Alright guys, welcome back to the forest. This time round, we're going to take a look at the alternate ending. I want to show you this too. Look, I've got full mutant armor on. Look at the state of this. Oh, look at it. It's got eyeballs and fingers and stuff everywhere. It's so horrible. But it's actually really good. I would recommend it, especially if you're going to the boss fight with Megan. The one thing that I do wish that they implemented into the game, I mean, I don't know, it still could be a thing, is that the climbers at the bottom of the mountain that you find, I wish you could use their equipment to just climb to the top of the mountain. Even if it means that you don't see anything, just for something like an in-game achievement or something. I've always wanted to do it and I never got the chance. All right, no more wasting time. I think this is the way it's done. I've had tips from friends on what I should be doing, what I should be looking for, and kind of events to keep an eye out for. But I think I hit the nail on the head when I found this last time. So, emergency shutdown. Let's do it. And the elevator's opened up. Okay, is that where we gotta go? Okay, so with that being said, if we've shut down the artifact, shouldn't this stop working then? Oh yeah, look, it's reset. Nothing's moving. I'm just using every last second to try and soak up the view. Although to the character, this has been a complete hell. For us, it's been a ridiculous adventure. And I don't wanna get soppy on you guys, but I mean, every single inch of this island we've explored, and from one location to another, we've built a home. And it's just crazy to think, I mean, after the previous ending, there could be a second island. I really hope they do. I mean, like I said in the previous episode, I'm going to support them with whatever they do, but I think I would love a continuation to this storyline. All right, let's see where it leads then. We're going to a brand new elevator. Use the card. I wonder where this is going to take us, though. Is it going to take us back down into the lab? Oh, I'm hearing noises. I'm going to try and keep you guys with me for this. I mean, if there's long drawn out sequences where nothing's happening. Did you hear that? It was like dislodged rock. Like it's not been used for a long time. What I was going to say though is if there's long drawn out sequences where nothing's happening, obviously I'm just going to get to the best points. Oh my god, that is terrifying. Okay, so I don't think there's any secrets to be found in this area. I literally just think this is like storage, something that's just been put down here out of the way. There's a little plant pot there, which seems out of place. Imagine if you could like grow a baby Groot or something. Have a baby Groot as a companion in the forest. How sick would that be? All right, let's descend into the depths one more time. Get some alcohol. Now, why are they giving us alcohol? Is there gonna be another fight? I think there might be. I feel like I know this cave system, but then I don't. Like, certain angles of the cave just look completely different. Yeah, I don't think I've been down here. At least I don't think it's connected to a cave we've been to before. Yeah, no, this is different. And that's a hell of a drop. Alright, let's go. I mean, all I'm saying, guys, is I'm glad that I've got my mutant armor on, just in case we do run into anything. I have got a lot of supplies this time round, whereas in the previous video, I really didn't have anything. It was just a good job that we were where we were in the game and we could see the ending. Again, though, the game is so dark. There's a little bit of light down here, but the game is so dark. All right, we've got a waterway. Here we go. There's two ways. Does this not lead anywhere? I don't think it does. Let's stay on top of the water so we can see what's happening. I'm trying to take it all in with you guys for the very first time. Okay, so I found two different ways that we can go. We can either descend even further into this cave system, or we can go that way. I wanted to show you guys this too. I don't know if you can see it. Let me apply some cloth to this stick real quick. I want to show you guys this because it was such a pain to make. But this is the warm suit. And the ingredients for it, like I said, they can be an absolute nightmare to get because obviously when you're looking for animals in the forest, they're not always there. But this thing really does work and it's almost instant as well. Whenever you're cold, you throw this thing on and you're good. And it actually looks really good too. I'm going to throw a picture on the screen of what it looks like with the character in the full image. All right, I think what we're going to do then, because I actually have no idea where to go, we're just going to keep following it this way. Oh, there's one of those things down there that kind of lights the path. And when I say, guys, that people have been giving me, like, helpful tips, nobody spoiled this for me. So, again, I'm experiencing this with you for the very first time. They've just kind of given me helpful tips so I'm not running around like a headless chicken. Right, what we got? We've got some boxes. We've seen all that sort of stuff. We've got some more cases there. It's a little bit worrying that they've left stuff behind like this because it normally indicates that I'm going to see something or get into a fight with something. What's that? Is that different? I'm hearing something too. What is that? I can't put rocks on this pressure plate. Okay, let's just keep going then. I have no idea what I'm supposed to place on that. At least, have I got rocks? Yeah, I've got rocks, so it should. This thing looks different though. It looks different than the other pressure plates that I've seen. Look, it's got like a... it's got like a really weird fixture in the middle. I don't remember coming across anything in the forest that has that. Okay, so I have no idea what fits on that pressure plate. It's nothing like I've ever seen before in the game. There is another way we can go, so hopefully that we can maybe fight something or collect something and then come back this way. Because there's obviously something behind that door. It's emitting like a blue glow, and there's like a noise which is really familiar. It sounds like the area where Timmy is when we first find him. Is it this way? Right, I'm going to try and keep lighting this because I know I keep saying it, but the game is super dark. Not just for you guys in the video, but for me too, even if we change the color grading. Right, let's keep going. Waiting for those jump scares. This is definitely new though. I've never been down in this cave before. Okay, is that where they left us resources? Because we're going to have to fight a load of cannibals. Right, let me get rid of this. Throw some TNT. I was half expecting something to run through. Oh, there's an entrance. Okay, what is this cannibal doing? Okay, I'm just gonna go ahead and say it. I don't think these cannibals were supposed to show up here. Especially you. You ruined that moment for me. I can never get that moment back. Okay, that's that. I managed to get rid of them the only way I know how. Of course they would spoil that for me. I can never get that moment back, but I am going to go back and think about it. So we saw a plane that went across the skies. Obviously, we haven't ever seen that while being on the island. And I'm guessing that's a consequence of shutting the system down. So that artifact can't fire that EMP burst and bring the planes down. Second, he brought out the picture of Timmy and then he burnt it, almost like he's given up the fight for Timmy, you know? It's weird. It's like It's something I said a while back in the series where it's almost like, what if we never find Timmy and we reside ourselves to having to look after this island so no one else suffers the same fate? I don't know. It was kind of peaceful. And I did like it. It was just that the cannibals ruined it. Of course they did. They've ruined everything since I've been here. But I mean, it was really cool. Nice to see the planes going across the sky. I've actually got some footage of when I was playing with other survivors and I saw planes going across the sky. So I'll show you guys that now. So as you guys could see from that footage there, there was just planes flying overhead, and we didn't just spot one, we spotted them a couple of times. One when we were at Goose Lake, one when we were just roaming around the other side of the map, and I don't know if the survivors triggered an event to make that happen. In fact, I think I could be playing on the same save where they actually completed both endings, so that might be a consequence of being able to do that. You can just see the planes flying overhead. The game doesn't want to let me go today without a fight, guys. I'm telling you all. When I was back up... Leave me alone! When I was back up top of the snow biome, there was a group of cannibals, and then an armsy came in. And now look. It's like they're pleading with me not to leave. Okay, we finally made it back to the... I'm not kidding, guys. Like, I don't know what it is, but the cannibals do not want to let up today. Like, usually I can play the game and I don't hardly see a cannibal. Today, I've seen like 50 of them. Look, there's more over there. You can see them in the tree line. They're still waiting for me to come on shore. So, I've got two theories with this. There is a door down here that was added in the update, and there is a second door that I still don't know what's behind. If you've been down in the Sahara Labs, in the kind of nursery area or where the kind of children's beds are, there's a red door with a keypad. And I've still not been able to see behind that. So, we'll see. Alright, what can we get? Some alcohol. Okay, we can go behind this one. Let's take a look then. Look, you can hear them! The cannibals, they're still waiting for me to go ashore! Let's go. Okay, so we use this key card. Is it open? What is that? Okay, I've been staring at this thing for, this is no exaggeration, around 10 minutes. And I'm trying to rewind my mind as to where the island or clues that we've found could have mentioned something like this. I know what I think I've got to do with it because it's got the kind of same fixture as what the pressure plate needed. You can see the button there. It's got kind of flat sides on either side where it's going to slot straight into place. And I think that's going to open the door down in the caves. But I have no idea where this has come from. My memory might be a little bit hazy about the forest, but if somebody remembers any mention of this thing, then please let me know in the comments. Because for the life of me, I can't remember what this is supposed to be. Alright, with that being said, it's now daytime as well. You guys remember when we first came here, it was nighttime. Look at this, it's now daytime. So I'm hoping the cannibals have gone. Alright, let's get back to shore. And I'm going to make my way back to the cave. And hopefully we're going to find out the answers to what's behind that door. I'm so weirded out by what that thing is, though. All right, guys, we're back. So we should have everything we need now in order to open this door. And I've done a lot of thinking on the way back here too. All right, let's see. It's the key for this, but I'm still so confused as to where that's come from. It's really cool looking. What the hell is that? We've got more of the bodies. What is that? I am officially so confused. Okay, this is definitely up there with the weirdest things in the forest. So I've noticed something as well. When I left click, this thing changes to a red color. And then if I right click, it changes to a blue color. I mean, I understand this is an artifact because I don't know if you guys can see. This has got very similar shapes to the bigger one that we actually disabled when we shut down the system. So if this was on the ceiling, you can kind of make sense of it. But I have no idea what to do with it. There is an option to stab it into the ground too. Let's do that. Oh, that's cool. So what does that do? Okay, I don't know what's going on, guys. I've just changed the color to red and I stuck it into the ground. And look, there's just so many cannibals now. I don't understand what's going on. Oh, they're going so insane. Let me grab the armor on quick. No, 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 you're not doing it. You are not taking me out like, oh my God. Nope. Do you have any? No, I don't have any energy mix. Oh my. Okay, this is going to be a consequence of this artifact then. Oh my, they're just... Okay, what does that do? Does this thing call them in and make them go away? Okay, so... If you guys are confused about what's just happened, I think this artifact brings in the cannibals. The only time I noticed anything different was when I switched it to red, stuck it into the ground. Okay, I need to put the warm suit on. When I switched it to red and I stuck it into the ground, there was just a wave of cannibals that came in and they were not happy with me, guys. And then I switched it to blue, stuck it back into the ground, and they've all gone. Look, even arms is moving off. Right, do I have any... heal. Let me just see what happens. This is the weirdest thing. All right, I want to get out the cold biome too. Let me go a little bit shallower down into this area. There were definitely cannibals in the area, but there was not that many. This is insane. If that's what this thing does, it brings cannibals in, then it kind of makes sense because for the longest time, there was like a rumored game mode that Endknight wanted to bring to the game, or maybe that they were working on. It was like a horde mode. Which would make sense. All right, let me throw it into the ground like here. There's plenty of open area. I had no stamina the first time I tried to do this, so I want to wait till my energy gets back up. If the cannibals come in now, then this definitely attracts the cannibals. Okay, I was just about to say to you guys, I was wrong. But look at this. Oh my God, look how many cannibals are coming in. This thing drives them insane. I can't tell if they're protecting it. Or it just... It's like got them in a trance or something. I've definitely had cannibals that have been annoyed before with big groups like this in the past. But this is definitely a correlation to this artifact. And they're so aggressive. Okay, they're fighting each other. That's good for me. I'm just going to let it roll for a second to see how many I can bring in. Got a fair few of them. Oh my, I can see them. I can see them coming in from over that side. Look, they just keep coming in. Those guys have ran off over that way. But there's definitely more cannibals coming in. This thing is driving them nuts. All right, so Let me see if the theory worked a second ago then. If I switch this back to like a blue, how do I switch it back? Is it that one? There we go. So if I switch it back, every single one of these cannibals that are here now should leave. Oh my god, that animation is so slow. Oh, it is! Okay, so what I'm taking from this is, I'm guessing this is instead of a different game mode, this artifact has the power to bring cannibals in waveform, and it also has the power to make them go away. It's like it puts them in a trance when you switch it to red, like red for the aggression, and blue for like, you know, they've just got to go away. Like they're almost scared of it. That's so cool. I had no idea they'd do something like this. And that's what I love about End Night. The surprises, they kept coming. Now, you still interested? Nope. You can hear them, but they're not coming in. So the more I think about this, it kind of makes sense with this artifact. Because we've chosen, with the alternate ending that we did when we came out of the cave and then we looked up at the sky, we saw the plane, and then he burned the picture of Timmy. He was basically saying goodbye. He was letting go. He didn't want to bring that other plane down and have somebody in the same position as us suffer the same fate that we have of being in this hellhole. So I guess we've got like a little gift through staying here. We've got the power to make them go away whenever we want them to, and if we want to bring them in and exact some revenge, we can do that too. I can't decide which is my favorite ending. It did get a little bit spoiled by the cannibals coming in and trying to beat the crap out of me while the cinematic was going on, but I think both of them are fantastic. If I'm being completely honest, and if I'm going with my gut, I love the idea of Timmy surviving and being able to do all that kind of research, get all that evidence for what looked like site number two. And who knows, maybe if that is a thing and that could happen, then Timmy could come back and rescue us, like kind of role switched, and then we could go to site two with Timmy with this thing. I don't know. It's been an incredible adventure, and by no means, guys, it's not over yet. I'm fairly certain, like I told you guys, the devs are still going to bring more to this game. I don't think they're done with it. And if we get to play around with this with more content, I think I want to play around with it a little bit more, see if we can survive like a wave of cannibals. Okay, I was just about to say goodbye to you all. I thought that was it. That was pretty much everything that we'd seen in the game so far. And then I opened the survival book. I want to show you guys this because it's quite possibly the best thing in the game. If we open the book, there is a new tab called Family, guys. Look at this. We can build our own family out of this. So we've got Timmy that we can build. It doesn't look like it takes a lot as well. It's got some sticks. We've got the wife sitting down, Timmy sitting down. So, I mean, we're not going to be completely alone, even though we're left on the island. So nobody suffers the same fate. At least we can bring our family with us and keep them there. We're going to go completely insane with this. I'm definitely building this, guys. But for now, I am going to end. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for your support. And I'll see you all in the next one.